Guys, welcome back to Southern Extreme TV. Thank you for hanging out with me today. I've got a pretty cool video for you guys. I'm going to be going over a new product line from a company called Hancock Armory. If you guys have never heard of this company, they do a lot of cool things. And the specific thing that I like about this company is they make top quality titanium muzzle brakes. They make a bunch of different muzzle devices as well, but specifically their brakes, in my opinion, is what this company is known for. The two I'm going to be talking about today are the Saratoga and the Lexington. Both of these are set up on 308 platforms. One is specifically for a 30 cal, so you could shoot your 300 blackout, stuff like along those lines. And then your Saratoga is specifically designed for your 308, which I know if you guys have been keeping up with the channel, you see me do a first impressions video on this new Savage High Country, and that is what this Saratoga is actually mounted on, which matches this Tracked Optics that I just got in and got on this gun, matches it perfect. And so I'm excited to give you guys a full product review on the gun as well as this Tracked Optics scope before too much longer. But today we're talking specifically muzzle brakes and why, in my opinion, I absolutely love these brakes and will probably shoot nothing but Hancock Armory brakes in the future. So first of all, obviously they're made of titanium. So I know a lot of you guys are probably like, well, what exactly does that mean? And I'm gonna be honest with you, when they first approached me wanting to do a video and wanting to review some of their products, I didn't really understand what the benefit to using a titanium muzzle brake was. The first thing that I'm gonna point out is the weight reduction between this muzzle brake and a similar muzzle brake is phenomenal. And the reason that I really want to point out the weight difference is because it might not seem like it's that big of a deal, but when you start adding stuff on the end of a barrel, that weight adds up, and it's something that you can feel on the gun. It just makes a gun feel a little different. So in my opinion, if you've got a gun that's already set up, that's already shooting well, and you're wanting to take it to the next level and add a top quality muzzle brake system on there, you want to go with something as lightweight as possible, because you don't want to really be able to feel the brake on the gun when you're carrying it through the woods, or you're hiking, or you're going to and from the shooting range. Only thing that you want to be able to tell is that whenever you pull the trigger, the recoil reduction and your follow-up shots are accurate and quick, and recoil is non-existent. So the first one I want to talk about is the Saratoga, because it's on probably my now favorite bolt action rifle on this Savage High Country. So when I first got this rifle, I was waiting to figure out what type of scope I wanted to put on it. I topped it with the Tracked Optics and I started shooting. As soon as I got the scope, I took it to the range, started target practicing, figuring out exactly what kind of rounds I wanted to shoot and what kind of rounds this gun liked. And the gun shot well. The gun did have a little bit of a bite to it though, not something that is unmanageable or something that would make me regret the purchase, but it did have a little bit of a bite to it. So follow-up shots were a little difficult. You know, even when you were on the bench, you would shoot and, you know, the gun would kick back and you'd be even off the target, where you had to get readjusted to get back on to see where you actually hit on the target. So when I got the Hancock Armory Saratoga in, I put it straight on this gun and the next day took it straight to the range. The two things that I want to point out immediately with taking this thing to the range is the accuracy and the recoil reduction. Those are the two things that I benefited from on this brake. Now, the one good thing about this Savage High Country is it shoots Remington Core-Lock from Walmart, wherever it may be, 150 grain Core-Lock by Remington. It loves that round. It groups it really, really well. Sub MOA actually at 100 yards. And sub MOA once I got the Saratoga muzzle brake on there. When I first started shooting that round, I was getting right at MOA, so right around an inch group at 100 yards from the bullseyes where I was setting at. So the fact that I was able to put this brake system on here and actually get that group to go down below MOA and get it to sub MOA is something that is phenomenal. That's the idea. Whenever you start trying to do custom things to guns and adding things to guns, that's what you look for. You got to look at what you're wanting to accomplish and will it accomplish that goal. Dang, Yellow Jacket just landed on me. So the recoil was awesome. it went from me being able to pull the trigger and having to try to get readjusted to get back on the target to I could pull the trigger, feel a little thump, and then when I come back down and got settled, I was still on the target. I was still on what I was shooting at. So that just shows you how much recoil reduction that this muzzle brake system has. And then obviously the accuracy thing is the next big item for me. So the Saratoga on the 308 bolt action Savage High Country. I highly recommend, if you guys have never heard of this company, go and check them out. The next one that I want to talk about is I've got it set up on this AR-10 platform. This is a gun that I shot a deer with it last year. Mainly I built this gun, number one, because it just looks cool. And number two, I just wanted a gun that was fun to take to the range and try to shoot long distance with. And just a conversation gun. And that's what this gun is. But the brake that I put on this gun was the Lexington. And the main reason that I put this on there is because this is a longer barrel. For an AR-10 platform, it's not a short barrel, it's a 20-inch barrel. And what's cool about this Lexington is it has six prongs out on the end of this muzzle brake system. And doing some research in behind it, I didn't know exactly what that was for, but the idea behind it is when your bullet is leaving this muzzle brake, it actually takes some of that extra gas that is not expelled sideways out of your side ports of the muzzle brake. It actually shoots those gases kind of at a diagonal angle this way. So even the bulk of the gases that are coming out of a typical muzzle brake, you're getting that same recoil reduction, but you're getting a little added, or a little something extra, if you want to call it that, by these slots that are cut in up front. So putting it on this AR-10 is awesome. This AR-10 has a little bit of a recoil, mainly because it's a semi-automatic system. So whenever you pull the trigger, obviously you have that action that's coming back. So a lot of the recoil that you're getting is the action. But now on this gun, this gun was a little funny. It didn't have a whole lot of reverse thump. It was more of a elevation. It wanted to rise. Every time you pulled the trigger, the gun wanted to jump up. It didn't want to really come back all that much. It wanted to jump up. So with this muzzle brake having two slots on each side to expel those gases out sideways, you also have three ports that are drilled straight down on top. You have two small and one large. And what that does is it pushes those gases up and out. So what you do is you have a recoil reduction going back, and then you also have those gases that are shooting up, but they're pushing the barrel down. So that virtually eliminated my barrel rise. Daggone blackbirds are everywhere today. So that pretty much eliminated the barrel rise issue that I had on this gun, which is awesome. That's the only complaint I had about this gun. It's accurate, and it's a good bench gun, and it shoots well. But whenever you shot, it wanted to come up off the table and rise a little bit, which I was not a fan of. So being able to put this brake on there from Hancock Armory was exactly what the doctor ordered for this gun. And if you guys are experiencing the same issues, go and check out their product line at Hancock Armory. Take a look at some of their muzzle brake systems. They do a very good job of explaining specifically each and every brake that they make, what it's designed for, and what it tries to eliminate on your gun, or what problem it tries to solve. Now, I will say on this gun, I did not see an accuracy change. I did not see the accuracy get worse. I did not see it get better. It pretty much stayed the exact same, but it did eliminate that barrel rise like I was talking about, which is exactly what this brake said that it was going to do for me. So if you guys are looking for a top quality company that makes good quality products and are built to last, go and check out Hancock Armory. Go and check out some of their brakes. They're made of titanium. Apparently they're supposed to never rust. That's something that they actually advertise on their website. I'm gonna read you word for word. Let's see here. Hancock Armory, titanium CNC machine from one piece grade 5 titanium bar that results in unmatching lightweight, amazing strength, and 100% corrosion resistance, period. It will never rust. So that is awesome that they can put that on their product line for this muzzle brake, because that muzzle brake system catches a lot of those gases, a lot of those bad bad things that can cause rust, can cause gunk to build up, just cause a bunch of bad things. So the fact that they are willing to put that on their product line is something that's pretty cool in my opinion. So if you're on the fence looking for some top quality muzzle brakes, go and check out Hancock Armory. I know the two that they sent me out are top notch, and I will never, I ain't gonna say never, but more than likely, I don't think I'm gonna be switching to another company anytime soon. So go check them out, guys. Thank you for watching today's video. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure you hit that subscribe button up here in the top left corner. It'll mean the world to me. I'm gonna be bringing you guys along with all of my videos coming up in the future, whether it be hunting, fishing, product reviews, whatever it may be. You guys will be along for the ride. So again, thank you for hanging out with me today. I'll see you guys in my next video.